Blake X. This is another nuclear reaction. What's up, survivors? So, around the world, 12 reactions. Each day, a different band from a different part of the world, different country, for this entire week. That is the theme on this channel. And for those who have put in their requests on the infinite list, don't worry, because we will get back to the regular schedule for this channel starting next week. But for this week, we've got this theme going on, and I think it's pretty interesting. We've covered some interesting bands from interesting countries so far. We've done Slovakia, Italy, India, South Africa, Poland. So now, today, we are moving on to Mexico, and this band is Brujeria, a death metal band, well, death metal slash grindcore, according to their Metal Archives page, from Tijuana. And, yeah, this apparently has some band members in it that were in a lot of other influential bands, including Fear Factory and... too many to list. So I'm really not sure if I've heard Brujeria before. The name sounds very familiar to me. I'm sure I've heard them mentioned before. But it's like at this point I'm getting so confused as to whether or not I've heard bands already. I don't believe that I've heard this song that I'm going to be checking out. It's called Brujerizmo. And this is off their 2000 album, also titled Brujerizmo. yeah, so usually the way that I check whether or not I've heard a band before, or any songs by that band, is I'll usually check my playlists on, you know, Last.fm and Spotify, and if I'm really feeling like I've heard a band before, if they really sound familiar to me, then I'll check my old iTunes library, too, on top of the other two things. So I've definitely heard of this band before, I'm almost positive, but I don't think I've heard them before. I could be wrong, I honestly don't know, so we'll see. But this band was actually suggested in the comments this week by a few people when I mentioned that I was checking out bands from different countries. So they must be a pretty popular band. Again, seems like they have very influential band members in this band with long careers. And yeah, I don't really listen to a lot of Mexican metal, so this should be very interesting. I've heard a few Mexican black metal bands, but aside from that, and this band also, its lyrical themes are very much revolve around the occult and Satanism from what I'm seeing here. So, you know, that's right up my alley. So, we'll see musically whether or not it's in my comfort zone. I think it's even more interesting if it's a little bit outside my comfort zone. But we'll see, you know. I'm not the hugest traditional death metal fan. I prefer, you know, melodic death metal and, you know, death groove and stuff like that, technical death metal. But, you know, I'm open to almost anything. So, we'll see what we see and hear what we hear. Yeah, I think I've rambled enough for now, so I think we're just going to check it out. If you like this content, please subscribe to my channel. Leave this video a thumbs up. If you like it, thumbs down. If you don't, if you want notifications, click the bell beneath the video. A link to the original video will be in the description. Also in the description will be the link to the official Nuclear Reactions merch store, Ye Olde Nuclear Shop. So if you want to pick yourself up a shirt or some other item to support the channel, please do. There's also a new design out, one of the shirts. The design is based around this theme, Around the World 12 Reactions. So if you want to wear the memory of the theme on this channel, go grab that shirt. It's only 20 bucks. And if you want the traditional Nuclear Reaction shirt, that's still on sale for 15 bucks. So go show your support. But I love you guys even if you don't. So it's up to you. Leave the ball on your court. But all right, Brujeria. By the way, Brujeria means witchcraft. So for those who don't know. But I'm assuming everybody does. All right, let's get to this in 3, 2, 1, go. Not what I was expecting. That was probably the weirdest intro I've ever heard to any song. I'm no ready for my feet, I'm ready for. I'm like that riff. So not what I was expecting from traditional death metal. Maybe these guys are not traditional death metal. I don't know. But it sounds really cool. It sounds very riff-driven. Haven't heard any blast beats yet, which also surprised me. But I like what I'm hearing so far. Cool album cover artwork, too. The intro was like really bizarre, though. Like that little kid's voice singing or whatever. I really don't know what that is. If anybody can tell me what that's all about, let me know in the comments. Let's get back to it. So at first I was going to say there's not much variation in this song, but there it is. very, very guitar driven. Not very percussion driven at all for a death metal song, as far as I can tell. Very interesting, though. I actually like the vocal style being used here. It's not like the super low level kind of, you know, Cookie Monster vocals, as they call them, that you hear in a lot of traditional death metal. I kind of like the vocal style that's being used here. It's slightly more of like a snarl or a growl. I'm not quite sure how to describe it, but it sounds good. I like the hooky riff that they have going. I'm pretty much enjoying this one so far. Again, aside from that weird intro. So let's finish it up. Alright, there you have it. Brujerizmo by Brujeria. When I first heard that intro, at first I thought I had like clicked on the wrong song or like I was being trolled or whatever. You know, sometimes people will like upload a video that's supposedly a certain song by a certain band, and then when you actually play it, it'll either be like, you know, some type of like delayed Rickroll, or it'll be some like completely different song just to fuck with people. So I initially thought that was one of those kind of things. I was like, shit, did I really waste you know, some filming on something like that. But it turned out to be the legit song, so. Very interesting. I definitely enjoyed it. I think it was way too short, though. That's my main criticism. And it does say death metal / grindcore, so maybe, you know, that's probably where the short song length comes from. It's also one of the reasons that I'm kind of hesitant to, you know, do reactions to grindcore on this channel, because it's like, I don't really want to react to like a 35-second song, you know. Maybe several songs together. Maybe that's the answer. I don't know. But yeah, Brujeria. I think I have heard this band before. I swear I had them in some type of library on one of my old computers, you know, years and years ago. I don't think I've heard this song before, though. Because actually, I really don't think I heard this one at all, because I would have recognized that weird little intro, you know, and I definitely didn't. It very much caught me off guard, and I'm very interested now to, when I upload this to YouTube, to play it back and see what my face looked like when I was here in the beginning of the song. I don't think anyone suggested this exact song to me either. I just kind of picked this at random. I kind of picked an album at random off Metal Archives, and then I just, like, picked the first song I saw on the track list. And I said, oh, you know, I'll just do this one. You know, what the hell. So, you know, I don't think any songs specifically were recommended to me. I think just Brujeria in general was suggested in the comments this past week. Yeah, a very good song that was very much too short, and pleasantly surprised by how much I liked it. As I always say, I'm a sucker for hooky riffs, and this song had it in spades. Yeah, so this is my introduction, pretty much, into satanic Mexican death metal. if there's any more kind of music like this, leave it in the comments. Suggest things for me. Suggest other good albums by this band, other good songs by this band, because this is a band that I think I want to explore more of, and I want to do more reactions to them in the future. So again, the music was pretty much on point for me. I did get the lyrics, and they were in Spanish, so I translated them to English, and they didn't translate 100% correct, because that's Google Translate for you. So we're just going to work with what we have and see what they have to say. Today, Brujerizmo, something Satanism. Faith in the old is fucking you. Christ virus is failing you. It infects people by fucking minds. The Antichrist organism. Brujerizmo, dark halo, I'm assuming, from childhood. Satanism against everything. Christ failed. If they do not change the laws that govern, it is ready for negative. Today's machines are like people programmed against everything. I think what it is trying to say is today's people are like machines programmed against everything. And that's pretty much it as far as the lyrics go. So, very, very basic. You know, Christianity programs people, turns people into sheep. It's basically what it's saying. It's equating Christianity with a virus. And, you know, much respect to my Christian friends out there, but you guys know how I feel about the religion itself, and I am no fan. And, you know, so I'll just make this comment. It's probably going to get me some hate. It's probably going to get me in trouble, but I'll make the comment that, you know, who's to say it's not like a virus? You know, I mean, the way that it spreads and just consumes everything else. I'm talking specifically about, you know, what happened to paganism, especially the indigenous European pagans. You know, taking down all the pagan temples and everything like that, and, you know, forcibly converting people and so on and so forth. So in that way, you know, to me, in my opinion, it is very virus-like, so I can see the comparison. So basically a pro-Satanism, anti-Christian song. That's what I'm getting out of this, and very, very simple, straightforward, to the point. Not a lot of nuance here, nothing super philosophical. What you see is what you get, basically. So I'm always a fan of that message, being a Satanist myself. And Brujeria, that's something I never really had the chance to get into here or talk a little bit about. And I don't know everything about the Mexican version of witchcraft and some of the rites that they have there and some of the customs that they have, because I haven't really explored that aspect of it, of things. You know, I haven't really gotten into that cultural, you know, variation upon witchcraft. But, you know, Mexico is very interesting in terms of how much of a presence the occult still has there, you know, because you've got Santa Muerte and the Day of the Dead, and which is funny because even the Catholic Church can't seem to stop the upsurge of influence, you know, that it's had. And I've never been to Mexico, so I can't say for sure, but it seems like within the last few years or so in particular, Santa Muerte is enjoying a lot more, you know, worship and prominence. At least that's what I see and that's what I hear. Definitely on a level heretofore unseen in the U.S., let's just put it that way. And there's actually this place in Mexico called La Punta, I think it's called. And it's basically like a town square, you know, for witchcraft and sorcery, from my understanding, from what I've heard. And black masses and other rites are held there. So Now, again, while I'm familiar with satanic witchcraft in many ways, I understand that the Mexican idea of brujeria has some differences. And of course, it involves some magical practices that can be traced back to the Aztecs, you know. And I'm talking in particular about, you know, the black or the satanic brujeria, which, because there are also forms, you know, in which the practitioners consider it to be white magic or even in line with Catholic ideals, you know. But yeah, satanic brujeria, there's actually some, from what I know, there's actually some cross-pollination with voodoo. For example, well, not necessarily voodoo, but some slightly similar religions and forms of magic. For example, there's certain curses and rituals that use a poppet or an effigy, essentially, which, you know, not unlike a voodoo doll. I mean, there are some differences, but yeah, there's this one curse in particular, and it involves piercing a bone. I'm not gonna tell you what kind, because I'm not trying to influence people to do bad shit here. and then so you take a certain type of bone, and then you stick the whole thing. You pierce the doll with the bone, essentially, and then you stick the whole thing in the mouth of something. And I'm not gonna tell you what. and then you bury it. And there's a certain incantation that goes along with it. And, you know, you need the force of will and an attachment to dark energy. So it's not quite as simple as it may seem. But, you know, that's an example of how there are some similarities between satanic brujeria and some other forms of magic from that part of the world. And fun fact, voodoo dolls aren't even really prominent in voodoo, which is why I kind of walked back what I said when I initially said voodoo, because that's not really correct. Because it's mostly pop culture that's kind of made people think that. In fact, from what I understand, the dolls are more commonly associated with, you know, hoodoo and Santeria, and the will that you inflict upon these poppets, you know, could be a positive one. You know, it doesn't have to be negative. It doesn't have to be about death. So, you know, in other words, it could help heal, you know, rather than hurt. But yeah, some of the cultures and traditions surrounding brujeria are very interesting to me. So a Mexican warlock or a male practitioner is called a brujo, and a witch is called a bruja. So one difference between satanic brujeria and American satanic witchcraft is that brujeria is more, I think it's more inclined to utilize parts of animals. Now, before anyone freaks out, I want to make it known that I don't condone the harming of animals for any reason whatsoever. Unless it's, you know, it's for food or something like that. You know, I myself love animals, you know, probably more than people, actually. and I would never support anything that involved an animal being hurt or exploited in any way. But there are ways to use the essence of an animal without this ever happening. For example, you know, bones and remains from an animal that's died of natural causes already. Oils that are extracted from certain reptiles. You have some mind-altering substances, like DMT, which, you didn't hear that from me. Eggs, feathers, you know, things like that have, you know, ritualistic purposes and ritualistic significance. On the other hand, most of the branches of black magic, and I use the term branches kind of in a literal sense, because I believe all branches of magic lead essentially to the same tree. But, you know, what I'm trying to say is basically what I practice doesn't require anything from animals. And, you know, I'm happy about that because I don't want to be involved in that aspect. One other thing, from what I know about satanic brujeria, is that it is very much related to bloodlines. You know, the craft is basically passed down through family lines, and it has that feature in common, actually, with a lot of Eastern European forms of magic and witchcraft. And I speak from partial experience, because I'm very much the product of that kind of thing myself, because my great-grandmother considered herself to be a witch, and, you know, she would actually put curses on people and things like that, and she did that to someone, too. She put, like, an item in the corner of a room, and she put a curse on somebody, and, you know, I don't know whether it's stuck or not, and I'm not going to say who this is about, but, you know, from what I've seen, you could argue that it has had an effect, unfortunately. Yeah. I don't want to go into any more detail about it than that. But so it's very much in my blood too, you know, and that I think is where my sensitivity to, you know, the supernatural comes from. But yeah, so that's just a few facts on Brujeria that I'm aware of. And it's very interesting too how there's been cross-pollination now between, you know, the magical systems. Like, you've got elements of everything from Santeria to Hoodoo to Palo Mayombe, all kind of mixing together in different ways and, you know, informing and influencing different practitioners. But, you know, I've heard about this, man, and that's actually kind of where I stand on it myself. Like I see no reason why these different branches of magic can't intertwine, you know, sharing different perspectives and different energies. You know, as long as you have the energy, the will, and the purpose, it doesn't matter where the ritual and its symbols and accoutrements, you know, so on and so forth. You know, it doesn't matter where it stems from culturally, but it is interesting to me to see how different cultures have different rites and different traditions, which to me is like, you know, using a different road or a different path to reach the same destination. That's kind of how I view it. So that's just my little two cents on Brujeria, and my little reminiscence about some rituals and things like that. I refrain a lot from telling a lot of personal stories about my occult practices in these videos because what's right for one person isn't necessarily what's right for another, and I don't really want to negatively influence anybody. But I've noticed on the channel that I'm little by little opening up more and more about my interests in that area, and I think it's probably inevitable. You know, someday there's going to be some song with some lyrics that just kind of trigger memories or experiences for me, and I'm just going to start talking about them. But it is what it is. When it happens, it happens, and I'm not going to fight it. But until I feel compelled to talk in greater detail about that, I'm going to kind of refrain from doing so. But so yeah, interesting song, interesting band. Again, pretty run-of-the-mill lyrical material, but that doesn't mean it can't be potentially powerful or influential, you know? Sometimes energies come from the most unexpected places, man, you know? Especially in music. Places you wouldn't expect, so. It's very interesting, too, because with this type of music, I usually don't pick up any type of energy off of it, but I kind of feel like not my usual self now after hearing this song. I don't know what it was. Like, I didn't really expect this from a death metal band like Brujeria, but they're onto something, man. They've got some kind of energy going on. Because I definitely felt something palpable, you know? So very interesting, and I think I'm going to add points to it for that. And again, the music was pretty much up my alley. Too short by far. I think it should have been this could have been like a 5.5 minute long song, and I wouldn't have even noticed because the riffs were really good. It was really memorable. It's still stuck in my head. So I guess I picked a good song to check out. But if they have even better songs and better albums, let me know. Leave your suggestions in the comments. There's no reason the infinite list can't be expanded further. As for Mexico, I honestly don't know if I'd ever visit. It's not really my kind of climate, to be honest. But I could see myself, you know, being in California sometime and going down to Tijuana or something like that. I could definitely see that. It would definitely be interesting, and, you know, I'll never say never. It's just not a place that's prioritized on my list of places to go right now. So we will see what the future holds. Very good song, basic lyrics, but there was something powerful here that I felt anyway. Music was on point for me. So that intro was a little bit weird, and it was too short. Those are my main gripes. So I'm going to give this one a 10 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. Solid 10. So there you have it. Brujeria, Brujerizmo. And yeah, once again, leave your suggestions in the comments. Because I do think I'm going to be exploring more from this band, and maybe even more right off this album. So we'll see. All right, so around the world, 12 reactions continues. That's one more country checked off the list, and there's still some more reactions and some more bands from different countries to come this week. Next week, we will get back to where I will get back to taking the requests on the infinite list. That is it for this video, and I will catch you guys on the next one.